your victory, your triumph, your deliverance, your encouragement, finances, whatever it is, God has placed it in front of you. There is nothing left out of place with God. God has did it before the foundations of the earth. Everything is placed for you. You're going to run right into it. If you walk in a way that will profit you, if you're disobedient, you will walk in a way that doesn't profit you. But if you walk in obedience, you will walk in a way that profits you. How will it profit you? It will profit you because you'll pick up and you'll grab and you'll walk in what God has placed before you. Hold on, because you might be in the middle right now, but God has called you, and God is going to see you through, and God is going to take you to that place where he has placed it for you. Amen?
Amen.
1 Samuel chapter 10 and verse 6, here goes Samuel speaking a word to Saul. And he says, "And the Spirit of the Lord will come upon thee, and thou shalt prophesy with them, and shall be turned into another man. And let it be, when these signs are coming unto thee, that thou do as occasion serve thee, for God is with thee." And verse 8, "And thou shalt go down," see, he's telling him what's going to happen, "go down before me to Gilgal, and behold, I will come down unto thee to offer burnt offerings and to sacrifice sacrifices of peace offerings. 7 days shalt thou tarry." He says, tarry, wait. When you tarry, you're in the middle. When you tarry, you're waiting. When you tarry, you're standing. When you tarry, you're being still. When you're tarrying, you're waiting on the promise. You're waiting on what God has called. You're waiting on the place that God has called you to. When you're tarrying, he says, wait just 7 days and tarry. Some of us can't even wait 7 minutes and tarry. But he's saying, wait 7 days and tarry. And this is a man that has been anointed and called by God. And he had a problem waiting 7 days to tarry. Oh, we have a problem waiting 7 hours to tarry. We start crying when we have to tarry because we haven't seen it yet. We can't get our eyes fixed on it yet. We start to doubt. We become discouraged because we haven't seen it before as yet. And God is saying this day, tarry, wait, be still. I got it. I've done it. You haven't seen it, but it's already there.
Amen.
So what happens is he begins to prophesy just like Saul said. And everything that Saul, just like Samuel said, everything that Samuel said to him, he began to do. Saul began to walk in it. And here he comes to a place of Gilgal. And when he gets to Gilgal, the Philistines are rising up against him. Now the people, now his army is frightened. They're afraid. And he doesn't know what to do. He's supposed to tarry. He's supposed to wait because Samuel gave him a word of the Lord. Not only that, everything that Samuel said had already come to pass except for this part right here. He already seen it. God had already given him something to hold on to because he did begin to prophesy. His father's cattle was found. Everything was done. All he had to do is wait, but he didn't wait on the Lord. He began to do what Samuel was supposed to do, and he began to do the sacrifice. He was caught in the in-between, right in the in-between of what Samuel said, right in the in-between. He was caught doing what he shouldn't have been doing, and on the other side was victory. When Joseph was in the pit, the palace had already been placed there. He was in the pit. He couldn't see the palace, but the palace was there. God just didn't run and do it right before he got there. God had already placed the palace there for him when he was in the pit, but he was in the pit and he couldn't see it. When the Israelites were in Egypt and they had taskmasters over them, they couldn't see the promised land, but the promised land was already there. God had already placed the promise there for them before the foundations of the earth. God had already made a way for them. And when the Israelites were at the Red Sea, God made an exit on the other side, but then the Red Sea raged before them. They couldn't see it, but God had already made a way on the other side. And when the Israelites were in the desert and they were hungry, God already made manna from heaven. He made that manna from heaven already, and then he placed it at their feet. And when David was in the cave, he was in the middle. Saul was on one side, the cave was in the middle, and the throne was on the other side. God had already placed the throne on the other side. The cave was just the middle.
Amen.
build me a tabernacle. Build me a tabernacle and make sure you do it according to what I say, because it's a replica of the one in heaven. It was already placed before the foundation of the earth. The Lamb was slain. When Jesus got off the cross, he went to the grave. Imagine this. He walked past the brazen altar, past the laver, past the candlestick, past the table of showbread, past the incense altar, and right into the Holy of Holies. Right into the Holy of Holies, because it tells us that in the book of Hebrews. But guess what? Between the cross and the Holy of Holies was the grave.
Yeah.
Have you ever been